However, as I told you before, we almost never have the full population and unfortunately have to deal with samples. And because of that, we've in econometrics, we've got something called linear sample regression function. And when it comes to the notations, the only difference between sample regression function and population regression function is the presence of those beautiful hats above the estimates. So beta 1, beta 2, and the error term. All right, maybe I will show you once again the population regression function. So this is how the equation looks like in case of the population regression function, and this is how it looks like in case of sample regression function. So if we would like to estimate the error term of this function, we follow the same procedure. We take the actual value of y and we subtracted estimated value. So the actual value of y minus the estimates that we obtained from the regression function. I've mentioned the word linear a couple of times already, and therefore I think it's necessary to discuss what linearity is in case of regression models. So there are two possibilities for linearity. The model can be linear in the variables, and it can be linear in the parameters. So, and not a linear function in case of linearity in the variables is when, for example, the dependent variable is squared, or there's a square root out of it, or it's in the logarithmic form, and so on and so forth. So in this case, the model is no longer linear. And if we look at the linearity in the parameters, not a linear function would be if, for example, beta 2, the slope coefficient, is squared, or there is the square root out of it, or it's in the logarithmic form. Even though in both cases the models are not linear, what is important for econometrics is the second definition. So it is allowed for variables to be nonlinear. So x can be squared, they can be the square root out of x. However, the parameters must always be linear. So, and next time, whenever I say linear regression, what I actually mean is that the model is linear in the parameters, so that the betas are raised to the first power only. Therefore, it may or may not be linear in the explanatory variables, the axis. So once again, when I say linear regression model, what I mean that the model is linear in the parameters. So beta 2, beta 3, beta 4, and so on and so forth are raised to the first power. But it doesn't mean that x1, x2, x3 are linear or not linear. They might be linear, they might not be linear. It doesn't really matter. But what matters is the linearity in the parameters.